Now starting the program. So a very good afternoon to one and all present here. We welcome you to the second day of this faculty development program. Our own resource person, Dr. Durgesh Tripathi, has already joined, and we were waiting for Professor Dhananjay Joshi, who is Dean, University School of Education. And he is also the director of this faculty development program. So, Amit sir, you have joined. So, me and Dr. Amit Ahuja, we both are taking care of the things under the guidance of our Dean, Professor Dhananjay Joshi. So, to begin the program, I request Priyanka. You please play the Saraswati Vandana, which will be followed by the Pulgeet.
Yes, ma'am.
Ya Kundendu Tushara Hara Dhavana Ya Shubhra Vastra Vruta Ya Veena ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृति भीः एवैः सदा वंदिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्यापहा
का सवेरा गुरु कृपा का होगा बसेरा विद्या की लो और लगन से हट जाएगा यह तम घनेरा इस धरा से आसमां तक बना ले अपनी ज्ञान गरिमा अपने श्रम से कौशलों से हम बढ़ा ले अपनी मान महिमा फैल जाए अपनी सुगंध हर दिशा में प्रगति पथ पर ख्याति अपने हो हवा में इंद्रप्रस्थ को करते नमन पाले गुरु
हेलो, यस प्रोफेसर धनंजय जोशी, डीन यूनिवर्सिटी स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड द वर्कशॉप ऑफ दिस डायरेक्टर हैज आल्सो जॉइंड. सो वी वेलकम यू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड आवर एक्सपर्ट्स. डॉक्टर दुर्गेश त्रिपाठी हैज आल्सो जॉइंड. सो नाउ आई एम फॉर्मली इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द रिसोर्स पर्सन ऑफ द डे. डॉक्टर दुर्गेश त्रिपाठी इज द फाउंडिंग फैकल्टी ऑफ University School of Mass Communication at Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, and he is also the coordinator MOOCs in our university. Dr. Durgesh has received Bhartendu Harish Chandra Award on the book by Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India, in 2007, Social Science Research, ICSSR Delhi, in 2015. He also received postdoctoral fellowship by Indian Council of Social Sciences. Sir has completed many projects of UGC and ICSSR, and some are ongoing also. He has been the invited speaker at Rajasthan University, Shanghai University, China, Burpa University, Thailand, University of Technology, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, South Korea, Singapore, and many more. Durgesh has contributed a lot in e-Pathshala. He has been the co-principal investigator of production of 360 video modules. Three books are also in his credit, and the list is so long, and I have taken only few credentials from his profile. So now we welcome you, sir. Over to you, sir.
For some technical part, my a presentation in front of the esteemed colleagues, research scholars, and the participants. First of all, I would like to thank to the organizers that they have invited me to showcase my understanding, my knowledge about MOOCs, open educational resources, and how to combat with the situation in this time, like lockdown and pandemic. That's why we are here, and I feel very happy, very adorable to present in front of my esteemed colleagues, which I would like to thank all the organizers that they have invited me to present my presentation in front of my esteemed colleagues. Especially, I would like to thank Dean, University School of Education, Professor Dhananjay Joshiji. He organizes and before this and the back of this FDP, Dr. Amit Ahuja ji, Dr. Anjali Sokin ji, and must be there some research scholars behind the team. And I must appreciate, must thankful, must congratulate to all of you that you have done a marvelous job in the pandemic, in the lockdown situation. And we can admire our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Padmasri Professor Mahesh Verma ji, for his leadership, for his patronage, for his esteemed leadership to our university. That's why we are able to present and to combat to this situation of pandemic and lockdown. I must appreciate to all the participants that they have spared the time to participate in a very useful, informative, and more or less objective to get your future prospects with this FDP. And we should go forward and to combat this situation again and again. First of all, I would like to discuss. I received yesterday a message, a kind of a piece of a message from my colleague, Dr. Sachin Bharti, in which the coverage of a news done by some news website, in which they have covered information in news related with, in the coming sessions, coming future sessions of our university, will come with new amendments, new suggestions to accommodate approx 40%, or we may say the 40% of the choice education system comes from MOOCs. We can understand about the MOOCs, importance of MOOCs, and the future prospects of MOOCs. I would like to share another piece of information, very enthusiastic information and news related with the MOOCs. As you know, I am the course coordinator of a MOOC program, which is launched last year on SWAYAM platform, Society and Media. And I have received a communication from Ministry of HRD, UGC, and the CEC, Consortium of Educational Communication, that my course will rerun from 15th of May, just two or three or a couple of days after a couple of days. On 15th of May, they will start again, relaunch the course again. Whereas my course has already been developed and launched for odd semester, but they have introduced, they have understand about their optimum objective, reach accessibility towards the students, so that they have introduced this course in even semester also. And again, would like to share one more information regarding MOOC and open educational resources, that Ministry of HRD conveyed me a decision that minister has already constituted a committee for the all MOOC course to translate into 8 Indian languages. You can understand the power of MOOC, the power of open educational resources in the contemporary society, contemporary education system. And you can understand, if you will learn this course, if you will do this, you will complete this FDP, you will be able to understand about understanding, knowledge, and how to develop MOOCs course. And that is the best important part of this FDP program and the course. And again, I would like to conclude in three points. MOOC will rerun from odd semester and even semester, will translate into 8 Indian languages for broader maximum reach towards the students, towards the education system, towards the academia of our Indian education system. And 40% will be covered by MOOC course in coming years or in the future sessions of our university, our education system. Again, I would like to share some important my formal presentation, where I would like to state that I'm not going to present any rocket science or any alien kind of a things related with you in front of you. I would like to share, I would like to inform, I would like to educate about very basic kind of things related with the how to combat with the situation with your potential abilities. You can lead this opportunity for your betterment, for your future prospects as well. The MOOC course will enhance your skill, your knowledge, and your proficiency, your commitment towards the education system. Are you getting my presentation in front? Hello?
Yes, sir, your presentation is visible.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your prompt response. Again, I would like to share my formal presentation in front of you. My presentation will begin with my introduction. It's session one, and I have received information that my presentation will be in the two sessions, first session and second session from 4:30 onwards. That's why I have divided my presentation in two parts, first part and second part, design and development of MOOC proposal. It's very important to understand about how to design and develop your MOOC proposal. And this is the best outcome of this FDP. After FDP, I do believe that you will be able to understand about this, my to able to present and design and develop a MOOC project for your You are sharing your screen. Okay, it's okay. Again, I would like to mention some promo video, but there is a problem related with the connection or anything technical glitches. That's why I would like to jump on my second slide related with the one businessman. Author, Mr. Alvin Toffler. Alvin Toffler said, and a very important quote related with the illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. That's why this type of a quote I am including here my presentation, so that I can showcase the importance of learning, unlearning, and the relearning. And for as a faculty, I can understand this type of a relearn, this type of a FDP will promote us for a better zeal to combat this situation, to enhance our skill capabilities towards the new learning, digital learning, blended learning, or a flipped classroom kind of new understanding in our academia. Alvin Toffler was an American writer and a futurist and businessman known for his works discussing modern technologies, which is very important and to understand about the importance of the modern technologies, including the digital revolution and the communication revolution. And he is regarded as one of the world's best outstanding futuristic you can understand about the future, understanding about the future, belonging, about commitment, about their understanding what to do and what will be the important in the next step, or how can we develop our skill, our understanding towards the next step. Before I would like to start about MOOCs, we should understand about open educational resources, because it's an open educational resource kind of a things, kind of a pedagogy to understand about open educational resources. And OECD, it's an important kind of a phenomena where a organization is known as for the development, for the betterment of the society. And would like to start with my introduction. Technology with education is the most promising development in the field of education in the 21st century. You can understand, and nowadays it's very contemporary. If you don't have any understanding about technology with education, or a blended education, you can say, you cannot understand about the basic idea how to deal with the contemporary education system. It's very important. And we are doing in the day-to-day of our classroom. We are using PPTs in the classroom. We are showing some videos in our classroom. That's why we can understand about the importance of technology for our development. That's why we can say this is the blended kind of a classroom. This is the flipped classroom, we can see. And it's a part of our day-to-day life to understand about this same. Next, if you would like to state or to understand about this importance, it provides
is not global.
I'm showing this PPT to understand and to lead the education system with our understanding, with our education, your knowledge, wisdom of knowledge, with global learning environment, and to understand about what are the important rules to enhance your skill for the betterment of the education, for betterment of your career, for betterment of your society. There are so many definitions about open education resources. Hewlett Foundations, OECD, you can understand the OECD Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and its contribution we'll discuss later on in this after one or a two PPT. What are the contributions to enhancing and to establishing about MOOC and open educational resources in worldwide? That's why I would like to mention this type of a definition in front of you about open education resources. And there are two more definitions I would like to say. UNESCO, everyone knows about the UNESCO, the contribution of UNESCO for education, or the betterment of education. And UNESCO laid down a definition about open education resources, that teaching, you may think about the words that they have used, teaching, learning, and research materials in any medium, digital or otherwise, that reside in the public domain or have been released under an open license that permits no cost access, use, adoption, and redistribution by others with no or limited restrictions. And I have gone through the various sessions which will come forward in the next days or upcoming days in the area of DP. And there are so many esteemed speakers will interact with you, and they will discuss about what are the restrictions for patents, what are the copyright issues, and how can we combat with this type of a situation to develop your MOOCs project or open education resource. And that is the main important point related with to all of the faculties to combat the situation. Next, and definition of open education resources about OER are those teaching and learning materials that are available either in the public domain or under an open license. You will also interact with a person about open license to understand what is the importance of open license and how can you develop your project with maximum pictures, reading materials, contents which are available freely on digital platform on various domain, so that you can be able to understand about copyright material, open license material to use your MOOC program or any kind of a open education resources. And benefits of OER, there are so many benefits. Only one thing, if you would like to say, it's more or less various kind of opportunities to enhance our skill for our development, for your future prospects as well. But whereas government response about benefits of OER can be enlisted with some points related with advancing knowledge by unlocking information for the benefit of all. I think its first line and first point is related with the education for everyone, education for all. If you will do something for open educational resources or a kind of an educational resource, kind of a MOOC, you are the best contributor for benefit of all. You can understand this importance of open education resources. Next point, widening participation in higher education by expanding access for non-traditional learners. It's a very important point, widening participation. If we will impart our knowledge, our understanding in day-to-day on our classes, we can focus, we can reach maximum 60, 120, 2240, 300, maximum 500 of the students. But by MOOC, by open education resources, you may reach, your access may be thousands. And you can understand the power of open education resources and MOOCs as well for expanding your knowledge, your wisdom of knowledge towards the maximum students. Next, promoting lifelong learning. It's very important point, lifelong learning. In a MOOC, everyone or anyone, any age group, any class, any creed, any socioeconomic condition, they may opt, they may join the course for MOOCs for free. And they can earn degree, we cannot say degree, but a credit for their own MOOC course after completion and then pass. After that, they will get a certificate from Government of India, from SWAM, from MOOCs. There are so many authorities and bodies for that. And bridging the gap between formal, informal, and non-formal. This is the main important kind of the point related with the everyone. Bridging the gap, it's a gap between formal, informal, and non-formal, but the MOOC and open education course is bridging the gap between formal, informal, and non-formal education, we can say. And next point, leveraging taxpayers' money by sharing and reuse between institutions. It's a very important point. We all are the taxpayers of our country, and our tax will go and goes by different manners for the welfare of the society, as well as is the important part like education. And if you will contribute your knowledge, your understanding for the open education resource, for MOOC, you, after that, the money by sharing and reuse, you can, if you will contribute a MOOC course, if you will contribute as an open education resource, then your idea, your brainchild, your project will circulate to the every institution, every university, and every, we can say, the scholar of our country. It's basic understanding, most and foremost important point related with the benefits of OER. Again, we can discuss about institutional perspective, about what are the benefits of OER related with the institutional perspective. We can say as a our university is a part of the institutional perspective, and you can develop this about the same. Sharing knowledge is a conjugament with the academic tradition, and the public image of the institution may be enhanced and new students may be attracted. First point related with the academic tradition, you as the teacher, we are the torch bearer of the educational system. We are the torch bearer of our society. We are the torch bearer of our nation. It's very important that if you will contribute as open educational resources for MOOCs, then you will be leading by the society. You will acknowledge by the society for the betterment for the education as well. And second, the public image of the institution may be enhanced and new students will be attracted, can be attracted. If you will contribute as a MOOC, as an open education resource, as we have discussed in the previous slide, that we can contribute our best towards the open education resource about your understanding, then the reach and access will be fourfold. Maximum reach, maximum access towards the student, towards the academia, towards the scholars of our society, of our nation. And with your contribution towards the OER, towards the MOOCs, you will enhance your brand image of our institution, of our university. Improving recruitment by helping the right students find the right programs. And nowadays we are planning, and have prepared some poster kind of a promotional kind of a thing, and some videos I have seen some USS of our university, that they have produced a video kind of a promotional video, we can say, for the students to attract more and more for the admission, to get their admission in our university, to get their admission in our USS. This is the important part of this OER and the MOOC. And we can provide resource for the students and faculty. Okay. Next, supports learning and collaboration. Supports learning and collaboration, attracting alumni as lifelong learners. It's a very important point. We can understand about how to retain and how to attract and how to establish good contact with our alumni. It's very important to attract and to enhance our relation between alumni. We can understand, and we know that there are so many international universities are very, they are known by his, her alumni. They know, they known as a good academic institution by their alumni, so that it's a benefit of benefit to bridging gap between institution towards the alumni of our university, alumni of our institution. And this point and this slide is very much related with ours, about our perspective, that we all are the educators, and we have to understand our responsibility, our understanding first related with the open education resources and towards the MOOC. An educator's perspective is personal gain through increased reputation. It's the first point related with you, related with the, your institution as well. Second point, gaining publicity or reaching the market more quickly may result an economic advantage towards your institution. It's very important. Next, perspective, a record of teaching innovations, allowing others to build upon them, and leaving a legacy after existing academia. It's very important point related with the, our understanding. And about the learner's perspective, it's related with the students and the learners who will learn through MOOC and towards the MOOCs, towards the OER, and to get their benefit with the MOOC or from open educational resources. An independent learner who has access to the internet can access material from the best universities in the world. It's very important point to understand. It's very important. If a student from Northeast, from any part of our country, can access the professor, the contribution of the professors of our ESS, of our university, of our IP university, from IIT Delhi, from IIM Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Kolkata, or any place, or any professor, senior professor, they can understand and they can learn and they can understand their lecture. They can understand their, they can read their content, and they can enhance their optimum knowledge of wisdom. OER can promote informal learning wherein credentials are not needed. There is no need of a credential. They can earn, they can train with their MOOC program, with their OER. And prospective students may access institutions by looking at their materials made available by other institutions. It's very important. Again, it's very important to understand about our historicity, about open education resource and MOOC. And we can show this type of a historicity of OER and MOOC. How can be, what are the legacy of OER and MOOCs towards the better academic system, towards the better pedagogical upgradation of our society? In January 1999, University of Tübingen in Germany published videos of lectures on internet. It is accredited with first OER. You can understand what is the main important point of a historical journey of open education resource and MOOC. Again, we acclaim and we respect, we admire the MIT as a innovative education and the research institutions, MIT USA. In 2001, the most commonly known OER initiative came from the MIT USA. They have published a full page advertisement in New York Times about they are going to start a open education resource kind of platform, kind of education system, kind of pedagogy to combat and to enhance, and they can establish their innovative ideas through OER in 2001. With the advertisement, in New York Times. You can understand they had started their journey in 2001, approximately 19 years before. By 2002, MIT released 32 courses. 32 courses is can be acclaimed as a full degree program, postgraduate program can be acclaimed as a 32 courses with open license and set a precedent in terms of openness of university courseware. They had started a golden era in the field of digital education with OER, with the and establishing a concrete establishment related with the OER and MOOC for the future benefit of our education. By 2002, they have launched. In July 2002, UNESCO convened the Forum on the Impact of Open Courseware for Higher Education in Developing Countries, where the term OER was coined. And after UNESCO's acceptance and promotion and establishment, they have started their journey towards the betterment of our society and for their development. And next point, we can understand about the contribution of China. In November 2003, China opened resources for education. They have started China as a system, as a program of China Open Resources for Education, commonly known as CORE, C-O-R-E, to start their journey towards the digital platform, towards the open education resource, towards the MOOC worldwide. And they have started their historical journey with the agreement of MIT. And the program was started by Chinese university, and Chinese university started this type of a program to before that they have signed the agreement with MIT, and after that they have started their program. In 2003, CORE was developed in China. In January 2005, the report on giving knowledge for free, the emergence of open educational resources, released by OECD. OECD is a European organization, like ASEAN, like World Bank, like United Nations Program, UNEP, UNDP, etc. And they have started a evaluation kind of a study. In 2005, they have done a report on giving knowledge for free, the emergence of open education resources. They have released a report on the program in the same. In 2008, the first MOOC was offered by University of Manitoba, Canada. We will discuss in the next slide what is the difference between open education resource and MOOC, and we can understand about what is the main difference between OER and the MOOC. After that, you can be able to understand and you can differentiate between OER and the MOOC, commonly known as, and most of scholars know about the OER is the MOOC and MOOC is the OER. MOOC is the OER, but the operational system of OER and MOOC is different. And we will discuss in the next slide. Sorry. In 2008, the first MOOC was offered by University of Manitoba. In 2010, Stanford University offers a free massive open online course, MOOC, that draw enrollment of over 1,60,000. You can understand the power of MOOC. In UNESCO 2012, commonly known as Paris OER Declaration, was released for promoting OER worldwide. So that you can understand about the importance of this OER and MOOC for education system worldwide. And after Paris Declaration, the MOOC program and OER has been acclaimed, acknowledged by the academia from all over the world. There are so many points historicity, but we will discuss later on. And we can discuss about some initiatives. And if you want, we can complete this slide with single point. A Khan Academy. Presently, Khan Academy is very commonly known as and acclaimed and useful for the 10+2 students for the maximum of reach. And the Khan Academy was started in 2006. After that, they always keep going on digital platform, enhancing their platform, enhancing their skill, their knowledge, upgradation of their program and platform towards the education of high school and intermediate students, 10+2 students. And most of the parents, they know about their contribution of Khan Academy. And we are discussing about the higher education, about their understanding about their OER and MOOCs. That's why I have left the Khan Academy's contribution and the starting period, but would like to share. That's why I have shared this. And next, initiatives of OER and MOOCs in India. This is the main important. We can admire our respectful contributors. They have started their OER and MOOC journey in our country. And in this slide, we will discuss at the same initiatives of OER and MOOCs in India. In 1999, National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning, NPTEL, a project carried out by 7 IITs, the IISCs, IISCs in Institute of Science, and other premier institutions around India. They have started their journey with OER for the betterment of the society, to reach wider reach, to maximum reach, and to benefit maximum of the student. And we know and we understand our country's geopolitical, geoclimatic situations of our country, so that they have understand about the same, and they have started their contribution for OER and MOOC in 1999. Again, 2005, Indira Gandhi National Open University, IGNU, launched its e-Gyan course initiative to store, index, and perceive, distribute, and share the digital learning resources developed by them. IGNU is a great contributor towards the open educational resources, or we can say the content related with the distance education modes. They have started their journey in 2005. And in 2012 is the very historical year in our country about their OER and MOOC and contributions are related with the understanding about the OER and MOOC program in our country. And in 2012, the national policy of ICT in school education, they have started and encouraged collaborative creation and widespread resources dissemination of learning resources towards the scholars, towards the academia, or we can say towards the students, and for the benefit of the students, for their upliftment of the students of our country. They have adopted by Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, and they have started their digital open education resource and MOOCs program in the policy like, or commonly known as, National Policy of ICT in School Education. In 2014, the national mission after policy, after adoption of the policy, after establishing the policy, Government of India started their mission, and they have adopted a policy, national mission on education through information, communication and technology, and they have launched in 2014 to enhance digital education, digital platform, open education resources, MOOC kind of a platform or education pedagogy in our country, in India. Initiatives of OER and MOOCs in India. There are so many initiatives started and done by OER in MOOC in India, by Government of India, by Ministry of Human Resource Development, by University Grants Commission, CC, IGNU, and various institutions. But I would like to mention EPG Pathshala. It's a very important point or a kind of a understanding about EPG Pathshala's contribution. EPG Pathshala, which is the foremost and important OER in our country, which is acclaimed and acknowledged by worldwide. And EPG Pathshala is an initiative of MHRD under its National Mission on Education through ICT, commonly known as NME ICT, being executed by the UGC, was launched. It consists, you may think over that, and you may acknowledge and you can claim your contribution towards the EPG Pathshala. It consists of 20,000 plus e-texts, and I would like to request to everyone, please go through the to the EPG Pathshala website. It's situated or it's established on InfibetNet platform, and you may search EPG Pathshala. You may search, you may reach, and you may access more than 20,000 plus e-text, more than 19,000 videos, video lectures from the professors, from the reputed professors, 3,200 plus experts. You can understand the potential of this digital platform and digital learning in our country. More than 30,000 plus quizzes, 70 subjects, law, medical science, education, communication studies, communication and media studies, sociology, political science, psychology, philosophy, many more. More than 3,200 experts have contributed their best efforts, and you may reach there, you may go there, and you may find out the content, the written content, or a video, or a reference material, or the quizzes for the betterment or for enhancement of your own understanding, your knowledge of wisdom, as well as for the students. And you may share, you may request to the students, then they may reach and access. And I proudly I can say, I am the co-principal investigator, the subject communication and media studies for the same, for EPG Pathshala, for the I have contributed a little knowledge of my understanding in the sea, ocean of the knowledge like EPG Pathshala. Swayamprabha is a free DTH channel for education by MHRD Government of India, provides a group of 32 DTH channels, and you know the contributors from CC, UGC, IIT, NPTEL, NCRT, IGNU. Center maintains their web portal for the betterment of the society. And we can discuss again initiatives of OER and MOOCs in India. Again, Swayam MOOCs. Swayam MOOCs, as I stated earlier, on the previous slide, then we will discuss about the difference between OER, EPG Pathshala, and other platforms, and MOOC. What is the main difference? Then we can show it. A Swayam MOOC is a program initiated by Government of India and designed to achieve the three cardinal principles of education policy, like access, equity, and quality. We can understand about their three principles, three cardinal principles of education policy of our country, or we can say the global world. It's important to access for everyone, it's for equity, and it's for quality. If you will contribute best with your best efforts, with your best contribution, your quality is the most important priority or foremost important point. And after your contribution, if a scholar cannot access, what is the benefit of the same? There are so many books are flooded with the libraries. You may go through, but in this time of a lockdown, in this time of a crucial time, unprecedented time of a corona pandemic, how can you access your library? Then it's important that the accessibility is the important component of the cardinal principles of education. Your contribution can be accessed by everyone, then can impact to everyone. Then after completion of the same, the scholar will be able to deliver their understanding, their knowledge to the society. It's important point. Again, the objective of this effort to take the best teaching learning resources to all, including the most disadvantaged. It's very important point, best teaching and learning resources towards the society. Swayam seeks the bridge, the digital divide. And in we have discussed, and there are so many debate related with the digital divide. And there are so many my esteemed colleagues here with my in the same FDP, and we have discussed so many things related with the digital divide. How can we bridge digital divide? And there are so many problems related with the digital divide. How can we be impactful, our knowledge, our education, our system, our welfare system towards the everyone? MOOC can be the, MOOC is the bridge, the digital divide. You can, in our geopolitical situations, socioeconomic, very varied socioeconomic conditions in our country, the student can easily access, or we can say the access is free. They can understand, they can learn about latest knowledge, this is the latest understanding with the MOOC for free. And we can understand MOOCs, large enrollment numbers. Why we can say this is the MOOCs? Massive, large enrollment numbers, open, no mandatory qualification, open to all. Anyone can join for free. No restrictions of a qualification. If you are having the graduation degree, then you can join my PG course, Society and Media. There's no restriction. Fully online. You can reach, you can access at your home with the basic infrastructure of internet. You can use your mobile, your smartphone, to access and to reach course of any MOOC course. And course structured course content is an online course aimed at unlimited participation and open access via the website or a web or a digital platform. And the basic philosophy of MOOC is three A's. That is, anytime, anywhere, anyone, and anywhere. Means anytime, you can access anytime. Anyone can join, anywhere can join. There's no need to be part and to be associated and to be in your university, to in your college, in your department, in your room, in your house. If you have a smartphone, if you have an internet connection, you may join anywhere, anytime, and anyone can join. That's why we say this is the important principle for the MOOC, three A's. And PPT is related with the MOOCs, open content, free of charge, affordable, anyone can afford, of a MOOC program of a Government of India, scripted assessment and feedback, we can receive feedback. Learning community, there are so many community of learning, you can establish good contact with the learning community, and you can start your friendship, your collaboration for various kind of a future development. And self-paced and open registration, no restriction of a registration, anyone can join. Then you can understand about the power of MOOC. MOOC is the program where four quadrant is important. Four quadrant program is the basic idea of the MOOC program, where e-content of a PDF, copy of your content, e-books, illustration, video demonstration, whereas e-tutorial, audio video contents, animations, you can use animations to attract your scholars, to your participants, students, with virtual labs. Web resources, you can share links, open access content towards your students, wikis, articles, and self-assessment. You can start towards the student, towards the MOOC participant, as a quizzes, assignments, and MOOCs. And would like to share some national coordinators, the City Grants Commission, NPTEL, CEC, IGNU, NCRT, NIOS, IIM, NCRT, NIS, IIM Bangalore, NITTR Chennai. And this is the how can we start credit framework for online learning courses through SWAM regulations 2016. You can start the MOOC, you can produce the MOOC course, you can launch your MOOC course with certain points to include some programs. Learning course, open learning course to be available on SWAM, and you may start the adoption of the MOOC course from the SWAM platform. Credit transfer, courses related with the courses on SWAM permitted for credit transfer, and notification, SWAM to notify courses everywhere, every year, and choice of course up to 20%. But as I have discussed with my previous slides and during my introduction of this PPT and presentation and interaction with you all, about 20% was the past, and in the future, maybe the 40% of course will come through the SWAM platform and through the MOOC. MOOC online education, its objectives, anyone, anywhere, any time learning, learning at no cost, equity in access to quality education, and implementation about the launched on 9th July 2017, nine national coordinators has been deduced and regulations and MOOC providers around the world. There are so many MOOC providers around the world. Like I do believe that there are so many colleagues, esteemed participants are having a degree and they have done their course on Coursera, FutureLearn, edX, Udacity, and many more. And you can understand there are so many MOOC providers around the world. But the free online course is offered by Swayam, and free online course offered by Swayam, Government of India. And course distribution, there are so many course has been distributed towards their participation of the scholars, participation of their students towards the subject, towards the MOOC subject. That's why they have a pie chart about their participation, their need, about maximum course distribution by subjects. And Growth Hub MOOCs, there is maximum digital penetration, understanding, social media, digital platform. People or a scholar is available anywhere, and they are opting more and more MOOC courses for their betterment, for their understanding, for their credit as well. Course of action for MOOCs is very important point where we can make amendments to course of action for MOOCs, and the university through their competent authority, executive committee or academic council. And I would like to thank you, our Director of Development, Professor A.K. Saini sir, and Director of Academic Affairs, Professor Mittal sir, our deans, professors. And I recall, and I would like to share, our university, IP University, is working on it very fast. And in the coming session, you can understand the impact of their meeting, and we will be able to adopt the MOOC course approx 20% or maybe the 40%, as well as we will receive the guidelines from the University Grants Commission or MHRD. But our Director of Development, our Director of Academic Affairs is working on it, and our dean, our professors, and all the faculty members of USS and the universities are contributing their best efforts towards the adoption of the MOOC course in our USS. Course of action for MOOCs, step two, select the course. The university affiliating colleges to log on to the Swayam portal and select the course to be permitted for credit transfer through Swayam. That is course in high demand for which faculty is not available, elective courses or for supplementing teaching learning process. And we can assure you there is no problem with the teachers, with the number of teachers, and with the classroom teaching, with the face-to-face teaching. There's no threat towards the class teaching, towards the face-to-face teaching. We can add for their teaching learning, and we can take it as a supplementary kind of a things for the betterment for the students and for their benefit of the society. Designate course coordinator. First of all, you can designate your course of action for MOOCs to designate course coordinator with your department, with your university, with your academic institution, or with your institute. And after that, you can start this type of a to combat and to start your pace to adaptability towards the MOOC courses in your syllabus, in your the USS, in your college, in your institution. Disseminate information. The university college should widely disseminate information about selected courses to the students through faculty members, SWAYAM coordinators, mentors, notice boards, student forums, workshops, posters, social media platforms, and university website, etc. And more of the advertisement, more of the information, you may attract more of the enrollment of the students. Course registration. University to facilitate registration of students. Every student enrolled for the course in the university must register for the MOOCs course. And I will share some information, some website, some platform in the next presentation from 4:30 to 6 o'clock about how can we join, how can a student can join, how can you promote your student to enroll the MOOC course, and how can they do. We will share, we will discuss about the same in the second session. And after that evaluation, the host institution shall evaluate the student registered for MOOCs course based on discussion forums, quizzes, assignments, sessional, and final examinations. The university assist host institution in conducting the final examination. Marks of the student. The university shall incorporate the mark grades communicated to the all. Course of action for MOOCs, and this is the most important point. Certificate. On receipt of MOOCs completion certificate from host institution, the university to give equivalent credit weighted up to 20% for the credits earned through SWAYAM. No university shall refuse any student for credit mobility for courses earned through MOOCs. And in the last PPT, I would like to share some references from which I am able to prepare my PPTs and to information. To interact with you, to showcase with you, and again, thank you all that you have listened me patiently. And again, I would like to say, I am not interacting, sharing information about anything else related with the rocket science. I have interacted with you, I have shared with you very basic kind of understanding about MOOCs, and we should know about the basic understanding before that we are going to launch our course, we are going to start our course, we are going to propose our course and to make your proposal. In the next session from 4:30 to 6 o'clock, I will discuss, I will share, I will interact with you all about how to make your syllabus, how to make your proposal, what are the basic inputs will require, what are the basic points should you know about how to deal with the proposal of your choice. Thank you all. Thank you so much again for patiently learning and encouraging me time to time for my best efforts, for my best understanding towards your towards your reach and access. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Yes, I am audible. I am audible.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay, okay. Thank you so much, sir, for enlightening us about the MOOCs and the open educational resources. You also discussed about the four quadrants, and you also discussed about the UGC online learning guidelines through SWAYAM regulations 2016. The all MOOCs providers all over the world, you have discussed very nicely, sir. We are really aware of the MOOCs providers, so we are highly enriched in this session. You also told about the free online courses which are available on the internet and the course of action for the MOOCs. So you have discussed all the 7 steps which are required for the course of action for the MOOCs. So we are highly thankful to you, sir. And we will be meeting again in the second session. And we will try to learn more about the guidelines for submitting the MOOCs proposal. So now it's participant.
Anjali, Dr.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My question is to Dr. Durgesh Tripathi. Like we are since last 1 or 2 years being a faculty of the university also discussing a lot about this MOOC and every program. Though I have also joined courses and cleared also. But my question is that can we take this as a course for MS student or graduation student and UGC and other organizations, those are going to take them as a employee. Will they keep this as a educational qualification? What I understand is that we are getting it as a additional knowledge, but if we will keep this for our students, तो क्या ये ऐसा होगा कि आने वाले टाइम के अंदर स्टूडेंट्स का ये एजुकेशनल क्वालिफिकेशन माना जाएगा?
डॉक्टर दुर्गेश, यू आर हियर? हेलो
अमूल्य.
हेलो डॉक्टर दुर्गेश, यू आर एबल टू हियर द क्वेश्चन? डॉक्टर सुमित हैज आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन. I think Dr. Sumit, Dr. Durgesh is not able to hear. So you can ask the question in the next session. He will join again. He will again join at 4:30. So you can ask at that time.
Sure. Thank you.
So let's have the break, and again we will be joining at 4:30. So thank you so much.